So, have you ever examined a leaf under the magnifying glass? You may have noticed extremely small rectangular compartments in them. Did you know these keep the plant alive? And these small compartments are not just present in plants, but animals and microbes too. They are responsible for life and are called cells. Cells are the basic unit of life. Our today's guest is a cell. Please join your hands together as we invite him for a talk. Hello, I am a cell, and I am the smallest unit of every living organism. I can perform structural and functional roles in living organisms. I am different in eukaryotic and prokaryotic organisms. In eukaryotic cells, I have membrane-bounded organelles, like nucleus, that define cells' genetic makeup. Mitochondria provides energy, endoplasmic reticulum, help in protein folding. Golgi apparatus do protein packaging. Ribosomes help in protein synthesis. Lysosomes destroy the foreign objects, and the vacuole acts as a storage system of a cell. All these are termed organelles. All these organelles float in the cytoplasm, and substances like salts may be dissolved in it. This gives it a jelly-like appearance. The cytoplasm is also continuously streaming like waves in a calm lake. In short, I am like a fully functional factory, with different departments following different functions to make it run smoothly. In prokaryotes, I don't have membrane-bounded organelles. My nucleus is freely suspended in cytoplasm. In case of plants, I am surrounded by a blanket called cell wall, giving me strength, and then by cell membrane. I have a large vacuole located in center and a small nucleus at a side. In animal cells, a large nucleus is present in center and small vacuole is present at a side. I don't have a cell wall. I only have cell membrane. You yourself are made up of millions of different types of animal cells. Can you name some of them?